Cause nobody can do it like Mixmaster can. Come on,
I got the D-double-O style. And here we go again because it's been a while. You and me, your baby, don't touch that dial. I rock from Manhattan to the Miracle Mile. My name is Rock King and I'm a lady's choice.
Vi se nalazi tu emisiji Lufting.
Zdravo svima, vi gledate emisiju Lufting. U ovoj epizodi vodimo vas pravo u Kragujevac, na festival fotografije Fotorama.
Nalazi tu emisiji Lufting.
Ja sam Marko Stamatović, kragujevački fotograf i predsednik fotokluba Polo i vi gledate Lufting.
I'm Lucia Giacani, I'm a fashion photographer working for Italian Vogue in Milan, and you are watching Lufting Show. I've been working as a fashion photographer since 8 years. I started my collaboration with Condé Nast Italian Vogue 5 years ago, so after 2 years I moved in Milan. I'm very happy to be here and I really thanks Marco for this invitation. I just arrived yesterday, this is my first day here and I'm really excited and happy to be here with everybody.
Tell me something about Fotorama festivals and your impression about that.
Yes. I really loved the organization, the program. When I first met Marco, he explained me, his ideas about the festival. I could tell he put a big passion in the organization. So I thought it was a really good opportunity and I was really glad to be part of this. What I can say is that when I became a fashion photographer, I was working already in a period considered a bad period compared to 80s and 90s, that was considered the golden age for fashion photographers. But on the other side, I'm glad to bring these witnesses to everybody here. Working hard, I still obtained a big visibility in this world, and even if it wasn't easy, I can survive doing my job. And so if I can give an advice in general, it would be never to give up. If you really believe in something, bring it on, work on it, and don't believe to people who say this is a hard world, it is not easy to enter if you don't know other people who already work there, because when I moved to Milan from my origin town in the center of Italy, a very small town, I just moved without knowing everybody. And I will tell all the story tomorrow during my speak. And I think it will be I hope it will be a positive experience, a positive story for all other people that would like to follow the same way.
I'm Erica Larson. I'm a photographer with National Geographic from the United States. And you're watching Lufting Show.
So I've been working as a magazine photographer for 15 years. And in 2010, I believe, I started working at Geographic. The way it brings... I mean, I can't speak for all the Geographic photographers, but for me, Geographic is... It's an outlet for storytelling that I don't think exists with other magazines just because of the dedication and the time that they allow. I mean, we have so much time to work on stories, and I think that... it's not that it's a luxury, it's just that it has to be that way. I mean, you can't, I think it's really dangerous if you tell a story in a shorter amount of time. You need to spend the time, get to know the people, get to know the place, because it is a tool to communicate to the rest of the world about a certain culture. And if you don't give up a lot about yourself and dedicate the time and open up your heart and your mind to listening, then what's the point? So to me, Geographic is supporting this kind of storytelling, and that's why I work there, that's why I want to work there. I hope that, you know, I think also, I really believe at this point, at least National Geographic in the US is really supporting younger photographers and supporting their different ideas and their different ways of storytelling. So I absolutely think it's a magazine that's accessible to all different types of cultures and different types of talents that are up and coming as well, as long as you're willing to dedicate the time and the effort it is to doing it. I think there's a good opportunity to get your work in there.
Can you tell me something, your impression in Fotorama in Kragujevac?
Yeah, it's exactly this. It's this idea of this dedication. I mean, I've been talking to Marco now almost 2 years. He was like persistent. He kept up on my invitation, and when I got here, everybody, there's no ego, there's no pretense. It's all about, like, people just have a hunger to learn about photography and also to share their photography as well. And I think that's really important. It's, at the end of the day, what's this all about? It's about human beings communicating about their cultures, about their personal experience, about their families. I think that's what the world is all about. So it's happening right here in Serbia, and so it's absolutely, it's a real honor for me to be here.
You visit Monastery Žiče and you after that go in Studenica, and what is your impression about our culture?
Yeah, that's really hard to say, because I have to be honest, like, it takes so much time to absorb this. I can't say in 1 second this is what I think. It's, I don't have any words, because I think I need some time to sit and absorb everything I'm experiencing. It's really breathtaking, but I don't have an impression yet, because I think I need time for it to sink in. Like, maybe you need to ask me in 6 months, then I'll have a more articulate impression of what I'm experiencing here. But I have to say, it feels really familiar.
What are your impressions of the festival of these past days, and will you be cooperating with Marco and with the Fotorama Festival in further years?
So, like I said, my impression is exactly this, that this festival is happening because, you know, the sponsors and the people coming in they're all here because of the heart and soul of the people that are making this happen. This isn't happening because of sponsors, this is happening because of the heart of the people that caring first and foremost about photography. And the rest of it is being attracted to that. So that's why I'm really glad to be here, because for me that's what it's all about. It's just about people's heart and their vision. As for future years, that's up to Marco. I would love to come back, you know, but I also realize that, you know, you need opportunities for other photographers to come in, and you know, people need to learn about many different types of photographers, not just mine. But I would absolutely come back just on my own time, just to experience it, and not as a guest, but just to come and experience the festival, absolutely. So.
Ja sam Vesna Ristović, autorka zbirke pesama Lek trave očajnice, a ovo je Lufting. Knjiga poezije Lek trave očajnice je nastao par godina unazad, skupljujući neka svoje osjećanja, misli, neka svoja saznanja, recimo o lekovitim biljkama, jer me to interese kao tema kojom se inače i bavim. Tako da je očajnica u jednom trenutku meni bila tako primamljiva, zanimljiva,
kao inspiracija
da počnem da govorim upravo o tome, i recenzent me je prosto na izvestan način i usmjerio da upravo zbirka i nosi naziv Lek trave očajnice. Baš zanimljivo. Uglavnom sam govorila o nekim svojim dubokim skrivenim osjećanjima, naravno i o ljubavi, jer čovjek ukoliko nema ljubavi, mislim da nema ni života. Jer ljubav nas nekako i podstiče i uzdiže, obori ponekad i to se podrazumeva, ali svakako je, znači, ljubav nekako najzanimljiviji motiv koji se u pesmama i pojavljuje. Skupljala sam poeziju na putovanjima, zapisivala na koricama knjiga, na listićima, salvetama, šta se pronađe u onom trenutku kad naiđe ta neka misao, je prosto zabeležim da mi ne odleti.
Vi ste inače profesor razne nastave, odnosno učiteljica, pa kako na decu prenositi, koliko deca danas zapravo prihvataju više knjigu, a manje internet? Kako ih vi prosto fokusirate i usmeravate kada je književnost u pitanju?
S obzirom da je veoma teško decu motivisati da čitaju, jer je internet upropastio svojim nekim konotacijama nekih sjajnih, dobrih dela, umetničkih dela, veoma je teško naći načina. Međutim, ja mogu da se pohvalim svojim učenicima. Svakog dana, na svakom času, bez obzira da li je to matematika, da li je to fizičko vaspitanje, bilo šta, uvijek se pronađe misao kojom ih ja navedem da li počnu da se interesuju. Mi pišemo pesme na časovima. Znate, to su neki pokušaji, to nekad deluje smešno. Završavamo četvrti razred i sad se smejemo nekim našim stihovima iz drugog razreda. Jao, kakvi smo bili. U stvari bili smo sjajni, jer je veoma važno da dete u stvari kroz te rečenice izjasni svoju misao, kakva god da ona jeste. Tako se otvori, pokaže neka svoje osjećanja, možda tuge, možda neraspoloženja, radosti, sreće. Zavisi kako se koga dana i to dete osjeća. Nisu uvijek srećni kad dođu u školu. Imaju i neke tamne trenutke. Kroz poeziju ih nekako izvlačimo, kroz književnost. Ja veoma volim književnost i uspjela sam da i kod svojih učenika okrenem ih zapravo da vole tu književnost. Posebno Andrića pominjem, bez obzira što je uzrast od 10 godina, ali vidim da vole i to je moj uspeh u tom nekom mom osnovnom poslu.
Kako roditelji treba da utiču na svoje dete kada je čitanje u pitanju?
Polazimo od toga da najpre uzmu da pročitaju bilo šta, da bi se navikli da čitaju. Onog trenutka kad pročitaju bilo šta, možda im se svidi ili ne svidi, onda će oni pokušati da pronađu sadržaje njima primamljive. Nek to bude politikin zabavnik u početku, u kome će biti veoma zanimljivih informacija, koji će ih motivisati da možda pronađu neku drugu informaciju. Pa nek bude to internet. Naći će oni i tamo korisnih informacija, da ne pljujemo sada, da kažem, po toj novoj tehnologiji. Mogu oni da čitaju na izletu, na moru, na odmoru, bilo šta u onom trenutku šta naiđe. Kažem, ne treba kupovati neka dela, jasni roditelji mora da imaju granicu, šta detetu dati. Ne može to biti delo koje govori, recimo, Draži Mihajloviću ili tako nešto što je njima teško kao tema. Ali mogu, ja uvijek govorim da idu u našu gradsku biblioteku.
My name is Steve McCurry and you are watching Lufting.
Gledajte.
Šta gledamo?
Lufting.
Lufting.
May I have your attention, please? Will the real Slim Shady please stand up?